So just as the moderator said, I'm Nicholas Odhiambo. I'm affiliated to Maseno University, Kenya. And this is part of my thesis. And the title, as shown there, was Computational Evaluation of the Effects of OpenFlow and OSPF Routing on QoS Metrics in a Live Simulated Mobile Core IP Network. Sorry, I didn't put my agenda, but I can straight go to the second item, which is the background. What is the background of this research for the thesis? So as we know, there is a global demand for IP access services, and it keeps on increasing. So that's a global phenomenon that we have seen. And we also know that the QoS values are some of the key performance indicators that determine how best a network is operating. That leads us to the next point. So what next? So in any network, of course, you will find routing. And I think in yesterday's session, there were aspects of routing like managed routing and so on. So routing is an important element in communication between different networks and how it's impacted by the size of the network. So just for background. So the QoS metrics that we discussed in this research were jitter, delay, throughput, and PDR, packet delivery ratio. So what was the problem? What was really the problem that we were looking at? In our literature review, we could see that multiple studies showed that classical routing is not able to address effectively QoS values. I could explain classical routing if someone wants me to. It's not effective, as studies have shown. Studies also show that mobile provider companies still use classical routing approaches in the core. When they do that, what happens? Quality of service is obviously impacted. And again, we know that, as we have discovered recently, that OpenFlow, as a mode of routing, the strengths are it's the centrality and programmability against the distributed nature of classical routing approaches. So that's now, I think, a well-known fact, where we go for central or distributed, and SDN, of course, talks, leans towards centralizing. So what were the objectives that we looked at in this thesis? So objective one was to evaluate the effects of jitter on OSPF and OpenFlow, effects of PDR on OSPF and OpenFlow, throughput on OSPF and OpenFlow, and delay on OSPF and OpenFlow. So what was really the justification? Why did we have to invest the time and to look at this? So mobile IP service is a key driver of most nations' economy. Many things have become mobile, if I may say so, from banking to chat to several other things. And all these are facilitated through mobile access. Again, studies by Araniti showed that the performance of OpenFlow improved performance of OpenFlow in a limited wireless network. So this was an opportunity to extend the research and to try to contribute new knowledge by examining a different network domain. And hence, this also was an opportunity to write this thesis for the master's program that I'm currently undertaking. So summary, a quick summary literature review was that routing is important, as we have seen. Jitter, throughput delay, and PDR are some of the important metrics that affect the quality of routing in a mobile network. And end users are always advised to be on the lookout for this. I think there's also the quality of experience coming in. So many approaches have been used to improve routing, as we know, but we find that they have this habit of still having the control plane and the data plane in one box, lack of openness, and that means proprietary, and then configuration against programmability. So approaches that we did review in the literature were machine-to-machine, MPLS, NBAR, and virtual route forwarding, which is Cisco proprietary. Those are some of the technologies that we reviewed. So open flow routing improved performance in small wireless and wired networks. So this justified the need to exhaustively test how open flow would perform in a large simulated network. Now when we come to the research design and tools, this study was conducted in Omnet 5.5.1, Simultel, PayNet. We also used the inbuilt OpenFlow. The topology, as I will show you in the next slide, was informed by mesh, and it's an hybrid, although we had to reduce the size, not to capture like the entire. And then again, this again is based on the school requirements. The methodology, the experimental, the study approach chose to use exploratory approach. As we explore as we move on, there are no hard goals on what to do and how they. So some of the key tools that we used that existed in Omnet and iNet were the scenario manager, the UEs, as found in the Simultec framework, you know, bees and a few others. So this was a summary of the simulation testing parameters. They are all captured in the table from wireless standard LTE frequency channel and the applications and the simulation runtime in minutes. And then the number of UEs that were incorporated systematically and gradually in the system, in the experiment, and the number of routers, stroke open flow. So this was a topological design of how we implemented the system. So we have the OSPF with the OSPF ready routers, and then we have open flow on the right hand side with the it's also clear that we used a single controller at the mobile core. And if I just go back, so we have just an estimation of this area here where we have the radio area network and then the EPC network and then the data center or the core towards the far right. So that because has been cut for it to fit in one screen. Then we got put up some interesting results. We couldn't put all of them. They're all covered in the thesis. It's quite a big one, it will be shared later. And the results, if we were looking at, for example, jitter versus the number of routers, so we have the application and then the jitter, of course, in milliseconds. So overall, we could see that we get less jitter when we use in instances where we are using OpenFlow compared to OSPF. So in the next, again, the next interesting result that we picked out was the PDR. So while on PDR, there is a It appears that OSPF performs better than OpenFlow, but this is related to the fact that OpenFlow has to better the jitter, which has more effect. So some of the control, I would call them control packets, would be lost because of improving jitter. But again, the results were not, the outcome was not significantly different, a standard deviation of 24. So that is also captured, I think, in the abstract that was shared. So what were the conclusion and the recommendations? So across the four metrics that we investigated, jitter, throughput, PDR, and end-to-end delay, OpenFlow seems to have a better performance compared to OSPF, and let's note that this is only a simulated scenario. So a further test, as we recommend, can be done in a real network. If at all there's a network with a test bed, with a trial test bed. So just again to note there, so sooner, like next week or the week after, we will have a multi-page paper with more details and a bit of change or progress on the data center. So again, just probably not necessarily important, but again, for the good of the developers, is that I have discussed with a local mobile company, and they allowed me to work with them sometime later, before the COVID. Of course, COVID interrupted a few things. So we were supposed to work with them to try some of the SDN technologies. It may not necessarily be open, but it was actually based on the findings that we had here and this abstract. So challenges that I faced during my time doing this, I had to do a lot of self-training, and because when I bumped onto a paper and started reading and got more interest, so I realized it needed more. So I had to do a lot of self-training, going reading through the manuals and so on. And I think it resulted in a longer time that I had allocated to complete the work. So thank you, and thank you for listening to me.